In the previous module, we have introduced the discrete time Fourier transform, that is the Fourier domain representation for discrete time signals. And the equations that we have obtained are shown on the screen. We have obtained what is called as the analysis equation, that is x of omega, that is equals to summation and ranging from minus infinite to infinite, x of n e power minus j omega n. And we have seen that this omega factor here, omega variable, is continuous. This omega is continuous and is having the range of 2 pi. So this is the analysis equation. And we have obtained the synthesis equation, that means the reconstruction equation of x of n. So this is the synthesis equation, as we are reconstructing back x of n from its Fourier domain representation, that is given by 1 upon 2 pi integral over a period of 2 pi x of omega e power j omega n d omega. Now this is called as the discrete time Fourier transform. Let us look at some examples. Example. Let us try to calculate the discrete time Fourier transform of a signal something like this. So let's have a signal, say for example, that is a kind of a sequence that is constant, something like this. Say we have some impulses, located from say from n1 minus n1 to n1. So I'll draw one more here. And for rest of the samples, the value is 0. Let's consider this signal. So it is 0 here and 1. So the signal is x of n, that is having the value 1 between minus n1 to n1, and for rest of the values of this n, small n, the signal is 0. You can see that the signal is 0 for rest of the values, and it is defined between minus n1 to n1. Let us try to calculate the discrete time Fourier transform of this signal. So in order to do that, we'll have to apply this x of omega equation, the analysis equation here. So that is going to be x of omega is going to be equals to summation, that is ranging from n minus infinite to infinite. So I'll, as this n, the signal is defined only between minus n1 to n1, we can have this range of small n from minus n1 to n1. So this range is going to be from minus n1 to n1, and the signal is going to be x of n, that is having the value 1 e power minus j omega n. So this is equals to summation n ranging from minus n1 to n1 e power minus j omega n. And if we make a change of variable here, so let n plus n1, let it be m. So what we are going to get is, so this implies this m is going to be, so this n is going to be m minus n1. So what we are doing here is the change of variable. We are replacing n plus n1 by m in order to simplify this summation. And in order to do that, we are replacing this n plus n1 by m, and what we are going to get is n equals to m minus n1. So what is going to be the range here? The summation as n, so here this n range, as it is going from minus n1 to n1, m range is going to be from 0 to twice of n1. So this equation is going to be x of omega equals to summation ranging from n equals to 0 to twice n1. So this is going to be m 0 to twice of n1 e power minus j omega m minus n1. So this is going to be equals to the factor of e power minus j omega capital N1 is constant, and I can take it outside just because this summation is a function of small m. I can take e power j omega N1 outside of this summation. So it is going to give you e power j omega N1 summation m running from 0 to twice N1 e power minus j omega to the power m. And we know from the basic math that this running sum from m equals to 0 to some finite number is given by, so this is equals to e power j omega n1. So this running summation is given by 1 minus a, that is e power minus j omega to the power 2n plus 1, 2n1 plus 1 divided by 1 minus e power minus j omega. We know from basic math that this something to the power m, where this m is ranging from 0 to some finite value, is given by 1 minus that something to the power of this limit plus 1, upper limit plus 1, divided by 1 minus that something. So this is equals to x expression here, and we can further simplify this equation. In order to make this in more compact form, I'm going to write that as like this. So what we get here is equals to e power j omega n1 times, I can take half of this yield common from this term, both of these terms. So what I'm going to get is that e power minus j omega 2n1 plus 1 by 2 times. So what we get here is e plus j omega 2n1 plus 1 by 2 e power minus j omega 2n1 plus 1 by 2. Similarly, in the denominator also we are going to get a similar. So if we take the half of the exponential common out of this both of these terms, we are going to minus. So this is equal to e power minus j omega by 2 times e power plus j omega by 2 minus e power minus j omega by 2. Why we are doing this adjustment is because we are going to get a much compact form of this expression. You can see that this is going to get cancelled, these terms are going to get cancelled, both all of these terms are going to get cancelled, and what we are left with, like if we can simplify this further, what we are left with is x, so this is going to be equals to, you can see from basic Euler equation, e power j theta minus e power minus j theta is nothing but 2j times sine theta. And denominator, we are going to get a similar expression. So this is going to be sine of omega 2n1 plus 1 by 2 divided by sine omega by 2. This is the expression for the signal that we have considered it here. So this is the final form for this Fourier domain representation of this discrete time signal. Let's take another example. Now, instead of calculating the Fourier transform, that is, instead of calculating the analysis equation, let's see what is the inverse of it. That means,